to sip a chair and sit down, get you gonna hear some news of the military nature.
I have a 70-year-old trumpet. It's been with me on all my combat missions, all through World War II. I never went any place without it. Took it in a little canvas bag tied to my parachute. I figured if I ever got shot down, it would go with me. Covering the beaches, we saw 2 million men, 10,000 ships. We had 3,000 feet as our altitude, and we just shot at everything we could, and we witnessed the invasion from a ringside seat. And I remember feeling pride and sadness as I saw the bodies, 4,000 killed in 2 hours on D-Day. 2 weeks after D-Day, we were the first fighter squadron on a strip that was built there. After a bad day attacking this German panzer division, seeing innocent civilians massacred that were held up on top of the tanks, that's why I had to play that night. As I took my trumpet out of the canvas bag at 10 o'clock that night, and there was still one German sniper, I thought to myself, that German sniper is as lonely and as scared as I am. How can I stop him from firing? So I played that German's love song, Lily Marlene. And I wailed that trumpet over those apple orchards in Normandy, and he didn't fire. The next morning, here came the military police up. And the military police said, Captain, there's a German prisoner down on the shore. And he keeps saying, who played that trumpet last night? There was a 19-year-old German, and he crying. He said, I couldn't fire. He stuck out his hand, and I shook the hand of the enemy. He was no enemy because music had soothed the savage beast.